From Virgil Ellis, is there a chance Mike Tomlin gets fired this year? I know the Steelers' year has not been great. I don't think that team is that good, though. Like, the quarterback's old. They can't run the football. They've made some, I think, questionable decisions with the draft process. I think to have the record they have is testament to how good Tomlin is as a coach. So I know at some level there's some fatigue with having a coach there for so long and not getting a title. It's kind of a similar Pete Carroll conversation. But I think if you're Pittsburgh and you fire Mike Tomlin, you're going to get somebody better than him. But I don't think so. So unless you want to go full massive rebuild, blow it all down to the studs, which, if so, why do you draft a running back in round one? That should be stupid. I think you keep Tomlin and try to keep winning games with whatever your quarterback looks like next year. So what do you think? Would you fire Mike Tomlin? Type in Y for yes, you'd can him, and for no, you would not. I'm not doing it, but I want to hear what you guys have to say. This is the pinned comment on today's video. So if an ad break comes here on YouTube, I want you guys to take advantage of it. Head down to that pin and type in Y for yes, N for no. Jim Panson 84, what are the most attractive destinations for veteran QBs like Wilson or Rodgers? It's a pretty deep list. I think Denver's a great fit. If the Raiders can get figured out, maybe Las Vegas. I don't love the Giants' destination because I don't trust their GM at the moment. I think Denver really is a good landing spot for one of those teams. If Miami is dumb and moves on from Tua and pays up all his draft capital, Miami could be a decent fit. Pittsburgh could be a good destination as well. Maybe Washington. I think Washington, New York, a little bit lower on that destination list. Beyond that, New Orleans is a really good fit for both those guys. Now, if you want to join these live mailbags, this is a great opportunity. All you have to do is hit that big red button and subscribe right now. It's free. All the mailbags are done live here on Chat Sports. So if you want in, hit that big red button and subscribe for free videos every single day here on Chat Sports.
Let's go to Real Boss. Do you think the Falcons make the wild card on they trade Matt to the Steelers for a first round pick? So in terms of making the wild card, no, I don't see that happening. And then would you trade Matt to the Steelers for a first round pick? If I was Atlanta, yeah, I would trade Matt Ryan for a first-round pick. I think you could even maybe get more. I mean, think about Stafford went for two. Carson Wentz basically went for one and two. So I really truly believe that, yes, you could trade him to the Steelers. And if I was Pittsburgh and I thought I was a quarterback away from being win now, I would consider this. The other issue is this. You have Ben Roethlisberger. You just moved on from him, or you're going to move on from him. To go to another aging quarterback on his downside, I don't know, man. Go to Doug Blazy. Which teams are the most likely to trade for Russell Wilson? All right, so basically Russell Wilson trade destinations. We're going to be doing a lot of these videos this offseason, so stay tuned. Make sure you hit that big red button that says subscribe. For me, I'm going to go ahead and say the New York Giants are going to be up there. It wouldn't surprise me if the Cleveland Browns came a calling. Look for a team like the Raiders could be up there. The Denver Broncos could be up there. I know Philly has shown some interest, though. I've been actually pretty impressed by what I've seen so far from Jalen Hurts. The Pittsburgh Steelers are going to be a team to keep in mind. Carolina Panthers are going to be a team to keep in mind. So off the top of my head, hopefully that's enough teams for a potential Russell Wilson trade. Now, if Wilson is traded, there's going to be sirens going off. There's going to be all sorts of craziness happening here. And one of the things that I love that Chat Sports does is reactionary videos. We go live, and if as soon as the trade rumors start popping, we're going to be making Russell Wilson trade destinations. And if he is traded, I guarantee it right now, we are going live here on this channel. So make sure you guys hit that big red button that says sub. If you're looking for other reasons to subscribe, we're free. More subs we get, the more content we're going to be able to make here. We go live at least 3 times a week if we don't get breaking news. And oh yeah, videos every single day.
From the past master, chances Tomlin becomes Minnesota's new coach. I think pretty much zero. I know he was briefly the Vikings DC before the Steelers hired him, but I don't think Tomlin's going to leave Pittsburgh. Now, if that ends up falling apart, well, then I think if you're Minnesota, you call immediately. It'd be a great hire, but I think it'd be a pretty low possibility from that perspective. Who is your top head coach candidate? Who is it? Is it, Matt Eberflus? He's been a hot name right now. Is it Eric Bieniemy, Kellen Moore, Dan Quinn, Byron Leftwich, Brian Daboll? Who is it? Let me know what you guys have to say in the comments. Your top NFL head coach option. Again, if you missed it earlier, the Fanatics jersey deal is available. chatsports.com/jersey deal. Under $90, a ton of NFL jerseys. Official Nike ones, by the way, from all kinds of different teams. All the NFL teams have a jersey for you guys. So whatever team you cheer for, they got you guys covered. We had the Tua question. Boom, there's one right there. Justin Fields. Some rookie jerseys are included for under 90 at chatsports.com/jersey deal. I'll put that link, by the way, in the comment section and in the description.
What up, Bailey? Most disappointing team this year overall. From top to bottom, I mean, I guess I'm going to go Seattle. I get that Russell Wilson has been battling some injuries, but, I mean, think about it. I mean, it's been a really, really big disaster. I might also go ahead and say Jacksonville because I know a lot of people, when they paid Urban Meyer the amount of money they did, they're like, oh, you got Trevor Lawrence. It's going to be a total change. That quite didn't happen. So I am, though, going to say Seattle. I think most people for Seahawks fans, also the Browns, had some high hopes on the Browns as well. All right, what is the biggest game of the week? There's a lot of NFL games. There's no Thursday night football this week. Personally, for me, when I look at some of these games on the slate, I'm going to say Raiders-Colts because I'm just a Raiders guy. But that Chiefs and Bengals game, that one really, really is interesting to me. I know the Rams have a pretty tough game as well. The Titans and Dolphins game has a lot riding on it. So please, let me know down in the comments section, what is the biggest game of the week? Let's go to Bailey. Biggest takeaway from this year from a fantasy football perspective. Now, my biggest takeaway is if you're in a fantasy league that does two-week championships, you're dumb. Get out of those leagues. ASAP Rocky. Sorry, Chugs. I also love two-quarterback leagues. If you're not in a two-quarterback league, get in one as soon as possible because the quarterback position, when you do two of them, it makes it so much more competitive. And then my last takeaway is if you can get one of those top running backs that you know is going to get a lot of touches, sure, you can risk some injury. I'm going to go ahead and take those guys because there's so many amazing, talented wide receivers that pop up every year, like a Deebo Samuel. Yeah, I have him on basically all my leagues. Those are my takeaways for fantasy football. Now, if you want to talk more fantasy with me, I literally got my start in this industry doing fantasy. I used to write for Fantasy Pros. I used to actually do their start sit. I did stuff for the Fantasy Footballers. I did stuff for Gridiron Experts. I did a lot of fantasy stuff, actually. And then I realized, well, not a lot of money in fantasy football. So I came over to Chat Sports. Now we do a lot of other NFL content, but I love it. I really, truly do. It's probably one of my favorite things to be able to talk about outside of just normal sports content. Now, I'm definitely more of a sports bettor now because that pays my bills, and I love betting on sports. But yeah, if you guys ever want to have any fantasy questions, please don't be afraid to ask me. Now, the new year is almost here. It's crazy to think that 2022 is here. Hopefully it's better than 2020, right? Yeah, it better be. Give me one of your New Year's resolutions. Usually ones that are like, I want to lose some weight, or I'm going to try to ride a bicycle, or I don't know, I don't want to drink for the entire month of January. Give me a New Year's resolution that you have. Throw it down in the comments section. Who knows, you might see it on a future show.
So who wins the Super Bowl? I think the parity this year means that any team that makes it outside of probably the seven seeds have a real chance at making a run this year. Let me know what you guys think in the comments section.